play at the arena all the way until their traditional Christmas Day game. While Iowa, their next opponent will be Sunday, and they will face off with Dakota. And then they'll have a pair of games with New Mexico Friday on the 10th and then Sunday the 12th. It's Sykes and Sims in the jump circle, and Sykes wins the tap. And McCray will run the show for the Skyforce to start. Johnny Flynn stumbles as he comes off the screen, but he'll be joined up top by Jeffers. Flynn behind the back pass. It's stolen away by Curtis Stinson. He jumps the route. Stinson takes McCray one-on-one, and the offensive foul. McCray set up outside the defensive area where the offensive player is protected. And Stinson let in with the shoulder. So the first foul of the game will be whistled on Curtis Stinson. We are scoreless. We played 20 seconds. Othias Jeffers and Johnny Flynn at the center circle. Now they'll get it down to the baseline. Left side, Chris McCray, 14-footer in and out. Rebound tapped out by Sykes, fresh 24. And the ball stolen away as Iowa comes away with it. Up court, Kyle Weaver. He'll shuttle the pass into Sims, and he walked. Had a little bit of trouble gathering the pass. And as he took it to the rim, he shuffled the feet. So still scoreless. 11:21 remaining first period here at the Sioux Falls Arena. Johnny Flynn is going to take it and take Jeffers and go across the timeline. Jeffers shadowing him on his hip. McCray gets it left corner. Jumper, no good. And it goes on top of the backboard, and it will be to Iowa's possession. Still scoreless. And we played almost a minute. Officially, the Skyforce have put up two shots so far, and Iowa has yet to put up a shot. They have fouled once and traveled again. So there's two turnovers for Iowa in their two possessions. That's an easy deuce. Alley-oop play to Othias Jeffers down low. Nice pass from Curtis Stinson. 2-0. Iowa breaks up top first. McCray up top. He'll go against Stinson. Outside, Mason. Now to the baseline left side with Pittman. He'll bounce on Sims. Drive it, spin it, in the lane and in the hoop. Nice hook shot with the left hand for Dexter Pittman. Tied at 2. 10:30 to go first quarter as Stinson loops the ball to Sims. Free throw line extended right side. Now Stinson on the return. Now Sims gets it back. Double teamed in the lane. Pitches it out. Three-pointer. It is good by Kyle Weaver. 5-2 as the first three-point shot of the game for the Iowa Energy rips through the net. In fact, after turning it over on their first two possessions, Iowa 2-of-2 from the floor. Down to 10 minutes remaining, first period. Pittman's going to bounce it again, left side. Couple of moves, left-handed hook shot. That one goes wildly off the glass. Connor Atchley will rake the rebound for the Energy. He will bring it across by himself. Now Stinson will set it up. 15 to shoot as he ambles towards the left side of the court. He'll yell out the play with 10 to shoot. Now he'll go in motion, try to drive on Pittman. Skyforce setting up in the zone. Ashley trying to bust the zone and drills the three-pointer from the right side. Connor Ashley makes it 8-2, and the Energy lead busts to 6. Johnny Flynn will try to take Jeffers off the dribble. Now we'll shuttle it to Mason. He'll pull up with a shot, and it goes right from the top of the key, maybe just to the right side of it. And Anthony Mason makes it 8-4. Stinson will now point with his left hand and then pitch it that way to Jeffers. Jeffers now will drive the lane on Pittman, fires it over him, blocked by Sykes. And the ball still loose. Anthony Mason comes up with it, pitches to McCray, the alley-oop too far. Now back to Sykes for the jam. The Skyforce looked a little ragged on the open court play, but Sykes made them pay. It's 8-6. Now here's a drive in the lane. Courtney Sims this time makes it over Sykes, and it's 10-6. 8:38 to go first period, and the Skyforce with Johnny Flynn on the court. Sykes with a pull-up jumper from 16, no good. Rebound comes to Iowa. Stinson's got four running with him, and he gives it to Jeffers, pulls up, sends it down to Sims, and he'll lay it up and in from the left side. Had good position on Pittman and able to squeeze it through. So Sims makes it 12-6. He's got four. And the lead grows to 6 for the Iowa Energy. Flynn, Pittman, he'll back it down. Try to go to the right side this time and hooks it off the glass. Dexter Pittman with 4. And it's 12-8. 7:55 remains first period as Curtis Stinson runs the show. We'll leave it to Atchley, right wing. He'll show and then give it to Weaver. Weaver gets the screen, gets the shot, and it goes. 3 for Weaver. He's got a pair of three-point buckets, and it's 18, make that 15-8. 7-point advantage, largest of the game for the Energy here in the opening stages of the first quarter. Clock reads 7:30 as Flynn dribbles up top, leaves it for Mason. Sykes trying to drive on Atchley, has it raked away. Atchley fouled him. Whistle comes from the baseline, and Janet Graham, and she will indicate the second foul of the game. And actually the first team foul on Atchley. A player control foul earlier by Curtis Denson does not count against the team fouls. Sykes at the line, the first of two, short. Sykes on the season, 62% from the line coming in. Out comes Othias Jeffers, and on comes Shy Eli. He is a 6'4 guard out of Evansville. Sykes, the second, rattles home. The two NBA D-League assignees, Johnny Flynn and Dexter Pittman, set up in the backcourt. Now Iowa will come to their front court, leading 15-9. 7:15 to go in the first, as Weaver has it up top, drives around Mason, now gets to the corner, Stinson, long jumper, it's a 20-footer, and it's 17-9, the lead is 8. Skyforce the other way with Johnny Flynn putting up a hand. He'll get it to Pittman, right baseline, spins, cut off by Sims. He has to get it out of there and gets it back to Flynn at the top. Flynn's going to drive, then gets back to Mason, can't handle a pass, and then we'll send it out to McCray with 7 to shoot. Now Mason, right side. Mason, couple of moves. Now a turn, a pivot, a fire. It goes with the shot clock expiring. Anthony Mason Jr., clutch. 17-11. 6:33 to go in the first. Stinson, he'll pull up for another 20-footer. Rattles it home. Curtis Stinson with 4. 19-11. And the Iowa Energy lead 8. Flynn taking a left-handed dribble. He'll work that way and then send it back to McCray at the top. 15 to shoot. Flynn against Eli. Flynn takes it in the lane. Now sends it to McCray. Draws the contact. Can't get the bucket to go, but he'll have 2 free throws. He's in amongst quite a few Iowa Energy players down low, and it was Connor Atchley who developed the contact. And Johnny Flynn taking his 6 minutes on the court and will take a seat, and Lehmeyer Goldwire will check on for the Skyforce. Goldwire starting all other games for the Skyforce coming into tonight. Goldwire is a 5'11 player out of Charlotte and averages 15.2 points per contest. Here's news, Chris McCray misses a free throw. He'd only missed one so far this season, but he does drain the second. 19-12. And Iowa, after starting raggedly, turning it over on their first two possessions, have gone to the bank numerous times and made numerous withdrawals against the Skyforce here in the half court. Well, I think we got Courtney Sims got caught with a hook. So Sims committing the foul. It'll be Skyforce basketball when we come back. The score, Iowa 19, Sioux Falls 12, with 5:55 remaining first quarter.
All right, we got tomorrow off, not the fourth quarter.
Skyforce counter with 5 of 8. And now Iowa gets a steal. Long lead pass up to Jeffers, and he will miss the dunk. Lost it on the way up. Thought he was fouled. Claps his hands in disgust as the Skyforce comes the other way. McCray in the lane. It's picked by Stinson. Stinson's going to go one-on-one with Mason. Here comes a couple more Iowa Energy players. Shai Ely has it blocked, but he will go to the line for a couple. Well, Theus Jeffers suffered the indignity on the last time up the floor. Skyforce couldn't capitalize. Turn it back. And Shai Ely. Eli, 6'4 player out of Evansville, 75% free throw shooter so far on the season, 10 points per game, makes the first. And the lead grows to 8 once again, 20-12, with 5:28 left in the first period. Eli the second, in and out. Mason picks it, And Goldwire will set it up for the Skyforce. He's against Stinson at the top. Now Pittman has it. Free throw line. Now to Sykes on the other side, right side. Loses the handle. Ball knocked out of bounds by Stinson. 10 to shoot. Stinson upset. He had a golden opportunity to take that one the other way.